Okay, good day. The Yamaha XT 660R mine. And in this video, I quickly want to go about my top 5 mods I have done on the bike. There are many more, and some will follow. I might discuss it a little bit. I've done a lot, which is also cosmetic or weight loss. But yeah, we will discuss that maybe in a later video. You should do these videos when you clean the bike. If you look all the way over there, that's where my camera is, because I have some problems with my standard. However, angle-wise, it shouldn't look bad. But we're gonna use the audio of the drift. That's why I'm keeping my helmet on, because he can't hear at all any of there. I tried to make a top 5, but it's a little bit difficult to really say, okay, this first, this second, this third. We'll start with 5. As filters or air filters. Why 5? Well, I'm not done yet in this progress. Obviously, I have a KNA air filter inside, which is a big part which gives some improvement. Obviously, if you come down, then you can see I closed up the back filters from your cutter. That's closed off, so no dirty air comes in. What I don't have yet is a stage 2 filter, air filter, which allows more air to go into the bike. That will be there at some point. That's why it's 5th and not 4th, probably, for me at this moment. Because if I have a stage 4 filter, that would improve, of course. On the other side, you have to do something with your Carter. So I got a nice Carter air filter. Obviously in blue, because it fits the bike. As you see, everything is blue. It's high, it's dry, so it doesn't get any water at all when it's standing upright. And when riding, it's quite protected. So yeah, that's my air situation. Like I said, we're gonna improve it a little bit by getting a stage 2 filter, like a lot of XT users have. But yeah, that's something for 2020. 4 is the tilt tidy. Instead of something till here, we have it a nice clean cut. You have different versions and different projects. You can buy an R6 backside and make that fit. You can buy ready set packages that fit there perfectly from off the road, for example. Due to me wanting to do something other, something special, I created my own. There's an whole build series on that online. It's very tight. I had to move the exhaust a little bit outwards, but it looks all fine. Maybe a little bit cleaning and spray paint. I got my Lego reflector on there. Obviously a brake light and license plate light. These weren't the original indicators I had in mind. These were longer. They just flashed, were cheaper, but they broke, so I ordered this one, and this one I really like because they move. And the other one of course moves the other way. So I really like these, and if I ever gonna change something with the mirrors, I might buy these for the front as well. But yeah, nice short ass tail, clean cut, not the most perfect finished product, but especially from a daily distance, it doesn't look unfinished. And yes, we are thinking about maybe changing it up a little bit, making it more one part. But it's not a high priority for me. I don't see it that often. If I drive by or on most photos, it looks good. So I did, however, make the end caps of the exhaust black as well, to really make a finished product there. Nothing performance wise other than weight loss, kilo and a half maybe, but looks are also important. 3 is something that I know not everybody agrees as a improvement, but I do, and it's under the saddle. There you have it, it's the lithium battery. I'm gonna put the saddle here for this for a reason. I chose for lithium battery for the couple of reasons. One, it has the similar output, but it stays more reliable over time. Yes, it might have problems with cold. However, it is the second winter. We already had a freezing night, and I don't notice any problems at all. It just starts, it just goes, no problem whatsoever. It's a little bit smaller, and instead of 2. Whatever kilos, it weighs less than 1 kilo. So, and again, 1.5 kilos gone. Doesn't work with performance, not really that much, other than reliability. And of course, you have a little bit weight loss. And how lighter the bike, the better. Number 2 are the steel braided brake lines. So yeah, steel braided brake lines. Beauty about these steel braided cables is next to Vector blue, the Bunyo bolts are also blue. So everything fits. And from ProBolt, of course, I got matching blue covers. That's not important for performance, but ook steel braided brake lines are important. Now, a lot of this work I done in week and a half time. One of the things I definitely feel a difference from was the brake lines, because it improved braking quite a lot, actually. More than I initially anticipated. Front and rear. Rear is a little bit harder to see. Goes underneath and up here. As you can see, it's dirty and whatnot very more. You should do these videos when you clean the bike. But yeah, the brake lines really made a difference for me. Especially the front brake was way too soft for me. And I can actually really, really brake now. Also the rear brake, I feel difference because I can lock it up a little bit easier. You have more feedback. You don't have the squishiness of the old rubber brake lines. Rubber can expand, so you part of what you do on the handle is expanding the brake line, and steel braiders don't have that, so everything you push goes through your disc. So that's definitely number 2. And probably one of the more easy ones to do. Then number 1. Because number 1 is the fuel mod, which is also behind the saddle. Again, this time we can let it off because I was hiding it. This is the fuel mod I have. You have the famous Kevin fuel mod. I decided for this one, which is made by a person here in the Netherlands. If you want one or you're interested in price or whatever, his Instagram is the easiest way to contact him. So his Insta is mr.moto_mechanic. We'll put a link in the description down below. But he makes these quite affordable, adjustable. I don't know if Kev fuel mod is adjustable, or maybe it's automatic. Haven't really looked into that. But this one is adjustable. It was for his place. I could have also got it ordered and sent by the post. But it drove to his place and he helped installing it. And he did that quite often because it went really, really fast. So thank you for installing it. By the way, the fuel mod also is available for the Tenerife. So just visit his Insta page and ask him, because he can help you with it way better than I can. Now, and if you look inside here, you have 3 dots. So 1, 2, 3. Now often it's at 1.5. I, however, decided with the cold weather, it seems to run a little bit rich. So I have it at 1.25 at this moment. It works great. And when I have a ride out or whatever, a meeting, I crank it up all the way to 2, because it backfires more then. But yeah, that's definitely the biggest change on the bike across the year I did. Also, feeling wise, you definitely feel change with this mod, so that's why that's number 1 for me. A lot of things I did in one small period, this one I did separately, so I also noticed the difference of just that mod alone. If you buy a bike like this and you ask me what's the first thing I do, it's probably still the brake lines, because of safety. But if you want to feel the difference, if you want to gain more, not per se more power, but more smoothness, fuel mod. Obviously, there's been done a lot more on the bike. Cooling lines, paint job here and there. I'm not going to go into everything, but those were the couple of most important stuff for this video. Now, if you want to know more about whatever I did on this bike, you can either watch the rebuild series or leave me a comment that you want to see, I don't know, whatever mods and changes I did on this bike. Yeah, that's the 5 mods on the XT. Thank you for watching.